Well, I'm working on another series about feminine energetic abilities. At the moment, I still wanted to make this video because I feel that some people need to hear this. 2020, the year that's coming, as well as the decade that's coming, there will be people that will ghost you. Why? They will just disappear from you because they don't want to face themselves. I'm going to keep it very short. They don't want to face themselves. They have expectations that they don't want to face because those expectations don't add up. And what they normally do is to project the conflict on someone else. And then they don't like someone and they break contact or there's a fight and they feel relieved. But what if they can't come with any excuse to blame you? What then? Sooner or later, their inconsistencies will become visible. And then you'll have questions for them that they can't answer. So what do? They just walk away so they don't have to face anything. Look, if you were a psychopath with a gun in your hand and you were about to shoot people and someone just walked away from you, just like that, that would be different. But you're not a psychopath with a gun in your hand about to lose yourself by shooting people. You're not about to do that. So, for people to just vanish from you without any explanation, as if you never existed, that's just low, it's cowardly, and it's not acceptable. It's not acceptable at all. Normally, you should call those people to an account, but this is what I'm telling you, don't call them to an account. Just think about it. Such people have shown with their actions and with their attitude over time, that they don't want any responsibilities. They just want things their way. When things get tough or there's difficulty, they just walk away. They don't care about you nor other people. Other people are shocked. Other people are left behind with questions. Other people are left behind with troubles. They don't care as long as they are relieved. So they are narcissistics, all about them being relieved. And listen carefully to me. Such people will blame you for their cowardice. Yes, they'll blame you. And they'll lie about you with other people just to get sympathy from other people. And later, they'll do the same with those other people also. That's how they do it. Now, in 2020 and also the coming decade, there will be people that ghosted you in the past that will try to come back into your life. Now, look, if someone it's a believer. They're born again. They're renewed in their mind. That's different. But God Himself will work it out so that you are sure that this individual is safe. Unless someone is born again, walking by faith, and complying with justice, you should not reconcile with someone. Let me repeat that. Unless someone is born again, walking by faith, and complying with justice, you should not reconcile with someone. You shouldn't. Let me tell you why. If they're not born again, they're not walking by faith, and they're not complying with justice, especially the last part, they're not complying with justice, that means that they just want to get rid of consequences. And they see that the best way to get rid of consequences is by saying, I'm sorry, and by being kind to you. Are they kind to you? Because they really won't be kind to you? No, they're kind to you because they know that if they're not kind to you, there's less chance that they can avoid consequences. It's all about them avoiding consequences. Such people, they just want to get rid of you as if you never existed, but they can't do that. Other people also know you. So you are a part of other people's lives. If they were able to erase you from the earth, they would do it because it's all about them. Some will attempt to take your life just so that you're not able to challenge them anymore, especially if they did very dumb stuff to you. Some people that did very dumb stuff to you, they don't want any confrontation, and they know that what they've done to you cannot be undone. They know that you know what they did to you, and they know that you're able to bring it up. Some people will come to kill you so that you cannot confront them, and so that others cannot ask you about them. Because here's the deal. People that ghost all the time, the new people that they are around will notice their inconsistencies. So let me give them a parable. Let's say you have John. John goes with his wife. He just left his wife behind, together with their two children, and she was pregnant. Joe did it. He just didn't want any responsibilities. Now, Joe is now living in, let's say, Mexico. He now has a Mexican wife, but his brother-in-law noticed that his story is quite inconsistent. Because Joe told his family-in-law that his business failed in Philadelphia, and that's why he moved to Mexico City to start over. So the brother-in-law, so the brother of his wife, realized, hold on a minute, Mexico City doesn't have that much opportunity for entrepreneurs. If you wanted to come to Mexico as an entrepreneur, you should have went to Veracruz, or you should have went to an industrial center, not Mexico City that's filled with crime. So the brother-in-law realized this story doesn't add up. And then the brother-in-law finds out that, hold on a minute, the name of this man, I can't find anything about him on social media, and even if I inform about him with authorities in Philadelphia, nobody knows him. So then he figured out, oh, this is a false name. He purchased a false passport. And then the brother-in-law thinks, okay, well, why would he do that? What does he have to hide? And then the brother-in-law found out that he ghosted his family. Now, what if this Joe didn't want any consequence of his past? He would have killed his wife and his children and vanished. And then requested a new name. Or he would have faked an accident as if his family died due to an accident. And then he would move away. But not all ghosters are that clever. So they just vanish. But if they were able to think things through, and if they had the ability, they would eliminate you and other people from the earth through violence so that they don't have to face consequences for how they've treated you or how they decided to think about you. I'm telling you, such people, they are dangerous. And I'm not overreacting here. The hurt you felt or the shock you felt by them just vanishing or dumping you like that, that's just a very tiny red flag of what they're capable of. If they had the money and the social context, they would get rid of you. They would remove you from the earth. Because they can't do it, because they don't have the resource nor the connections, they just vanish. If you have people who ghosted you in the past and they haven't repented, they're not complying with justice, then don't reconcile with them. I don't care how much sorry they are. If they're not complying with justice, that means they don't really want change. They're just sorry for the consequences that they're haunting them. They're just sorry for the fact that they did stupid stuff and now they can't erase stupid stuff they've done. I'm telling you, some people will invade your life just to build themselves out. If they did you dirty, they don't want to be in contact with you again, just to save face. Or if they did you dirty and what they did to you is not haunting them and you're able to address them, let's say that you now have a big following, whether it's online or in the business or wherever. So you're now a public figure with influence. And they did you dirty in the past before you became a public figure. Now that you're a public figure, all the people they lied to about, so they've lied to other people about you, all the people they've lied to about you are now going to ask questions. And they can approach you and inform you about all the dirty stuff they're doing. So now that you're a public figure and you have more leverage than they have, they may try to get to you just to bring you down so nobody will believe you, because now that you're a public figure with credibility, you're able to expose them. And you exposing them, you can even expose them by just being you. If they've lied about you, said all kind of bad stuff about you, and now you're just you, others will notice that none of what they've said is true, and they're exposed. So when you're walking in prosperity, when you're having your breakthroughs, there will be people that will look up, that will look you up, not because they're happy for you, but because they don't want your prosperity and your influence to exist. Because that's a threat to their relief seeking. They don't want to face their own thinking. They don't want to face their decisions. They don't want to change their mind. They don't want to unlearn stuff. They just want relief, and everyone else has to find a way to deal with the relief they want. And anyone that's a threat to their relief will face their anger. Let me say it like this. People that ghost you are delusional. If you worked at the company for 10 years and suddenly you vanished from that company, the boss can't find you, nor your coworkers can find you, do you seriously think that you can move to another country, or you can stay within the same country, get another job, and nobody will find out what you did the past 10 years? Your new employer is going to think, okay, but where were you the past 10 years? What are you going to say? So there are going to be consequences. They are delusional. They just want to walk through life without any consequences and without any responsibilities. And that can never happen. That will never work out. The fact alone that they're willing, despite the obvious, to do it anyway, shows you that they are delusional. Some people will not ghost you just like that. Some people will ghost you in an indirect way. They'll become upset with you. They will ask you to leave them alone. So they will show you they're upset. But they can't explain to you why you are upset. Why? Because it's not you, it's them. But they want to gaslight you. They want to blackmail you into thinking that you're the one that made them feel miserable. It's not you. They are miserable by their own inconsistencies. But now, because they don't want to face their own inconsistencies, they want to blackmail you into becoming their victim so they can unload it all on you and they are at ease. And when that doesn't work, then they ghost you. So they're delusional anyway. They are delusional. So do not reconcile with delusional people. That's my message. I'm going to repeat it loud and clear. Do not reconcile with delusional people. Delusional people are dangerous. It's only because they lack the finances and the connections that they didn't remove you, nor your family, nor others from the earth. If they had the ability to do it, they would do it. That's who they are. Delusional cowards. Not only are they delusional, but they're also cowards. So that's a double danger. Do not reconcile with delusional people. Only reconcile with those that are complying with justice. I don't care if they come back to you and say they're born again, they follow Jesus now. Are they? Are they complying with justice? Have they forfeited their decisions in the past? Do they feel different about the things they did? Do they still agree with what they did years ago? What are they doing to do better? They can't undo what they've done that was wrong. They can't do that. So for them to feel guilty all the time, that won't help anyone. But what are they doing to outdo the wrong they've done? What are they doing to do better? Where is their allegiance to contribute to the well-being of the human population? Where is their honor for the Most High? Where is it? Look at patterns. If someone is in a pattern still, and they claim that they're sorry and they want to move forward, they're lying. If someone really wants to be better, they will see through their own behavior. They will see through their own patterns, and you will see that they want to get rid of those patterns. Many of you have been trained to be filthy doormats for someone else's violence. Self-defense is a trap, so I'm not teaching self-defense here. I'm teaching practical sense. Not self-defense, because that's a trap, nor self-respect is also a trap. I'm teaching you practical sense. Do not reconcile with someone that is delusional. Never. You will only be inviting danger and destruction into your lives and into the lives of those around you. Don't do it. Be at peace.